The Disability Discrimination Act was passed into law in November 1995, thanks to years of campaigning by disabled people. For the first time, it was unlawful to discriminate against disabled people in areas of life such as work, education, and transport.
We had no resources, and yet we built a movement which mobilised, at its height, more than 100,000 people.
One of the key questions is why the government suddenly decided that they wanted to introduce a piece of legislation, the DDA. The only answer to that question has got to be it was because of the campaigns on the streets and the campaign in Parliament.
Going on the first demos, I did find a bit scary, but I took the attitude at that time I had nothing to lose. I was single, I had no dependents.
A lot of these demonstrations were really spur of the moment and were an expression of anger, and I think that's why they were so powerful and that's why they were so successful.
It was a scary thing to feel that you could be arrested, and I was arrested once for obstructing the public highway, but there was a fun element too.
For me, it was the most exciting moment of my life.
Actually seeing people give us a thumbs up and ask us questions about why we were doing this. Finally, you thought, we're getting through here.
You felt that you would risk a huge amount to make a difference, a small difference, you know, if you could. And eventually, the change did come.
The day or the week that the vote was carried and we gained our rights, I remember feeling a bit, oh, right, where do we go now?
The passing of the DDA was a bittersweet victory for many of the campaigners involved.
The DDA brought a certain amount of rights and equality for disabled people. Rachel Hurst, you know, referred to it, didn't she, as the train spotter's charter. She said you could now stand on the platform, but you couldn't get on the train.
It was basically unenforceable. Most disabled people wouldn't have had access to the court or couldn't have afforded to go to court.
Although the Act had its critics, the campaign itself was a landmark in the fight against discrimination towards disabled people. It also changed the lives of many of the disabled people involved forever.
All sorts of things have really improved for disabled people in that time, and there are completely new challenges as well.
And there's a whole generation of disabled people who won't know what we fought for 20 years ago. So I think this story is really important and it really needs to be told.
It's vital that we mark this anniversary. It wasn't just about getting a piece of legal paper. It was our liberation moment.
We are marking the 20th anniversary of the Disability Discrimination Act. Click the yellow button to find out more. Or check out our other films on the DDA.